Alright, massive congratulations to you if you've completed your low poly character right here. We've gone through thick and thin to get this thing done, and it's been a wonderful journey. You can tell I've actually taken a long time trying to get this thing complete. It's taken me much longer than I needed to because of, well, I had to actually edit videos all at the same time while I'm creating this model. So a lot of the times I'm actually slowed down just by that simple aspect. So our concept artist has done a great job here, and we've been able to translate it to a 3D model. This 3D model is fully rigged. We can change his expressions. We can do just a lot of amazing things, you know, with the rig controls right here. So you can go ahead and start playing around, start animating some things. I may actually create some extra tutorials a little bit later, and at the moment it's looking great. So very, very happy with this. Everything's working great. Rig isn't falling apart. The model's working just the way you expect it to. So at this point we have pretty much completed what we need to. We won't be doing any more on this at this point. We'll actually create and fix up some things later as we start our animation, and we can do those tweaks in between. So massive congratulations once again. You get a gold star, this amazing graduation certificate, and an amazing pat on the back for yourself. Well done. You've taken the time to done one of the hardest things in 3D. It's just taking this a lot of these technical aspects from start to finish. So there you go, guys. You should be very, very proud of yourself. So I thought I'd take this time to do a little bit of debriefing on our workflow right here. So I'm going to use this amazing PowerPoint presentation just to show you what the timeline is going to look like. Alright, so first thing we started off with is concept art. Now the concept art, as always, you need a conceptual artist to draw something up for you, because a conceptual artist will be able to make a character that is both appealing to the audience and that will work, and also draw up some of those reference sheets that I have somewhere in my hard drive there. I don't know where it is. You kind of get the point. You've seen those reference sheets enough already. So the concept artist, his responsibility is to give you a character that works for your vision. So go ahead and direct them. Just say, I want a character. He's a mouse. He is a farmer. Wears this. And he's about 35 years old, blah, blah, blah. And in general, a good concept artist will be able to interpret that and give you just a few examples for you to take a look at. And then you can direct him and add a few changes as you go. I'll make a separate video on how to direct such people or direct your employees, because as a client, remember, I'm a client talking to my concept artist. As a client, there are things and rules that you shouldn't be doing when you're talking to your concept artist, because you'll just absolutely drive them nuts, or you won't be able to communicate what you want to them very clearly. So concept art doesn't take very much time. It's just this little tiny thing down here. For them, it may take maybe 20 to 30 minutes or an hour just to draw up something really quick. Draw up some line art for you to take a look at, and maybe another 6 to 8 hours to fully paint the character down here. I'm actually not sure how long he took on this particular character, but I'm guessing maybe, I don't know, 5 hours, maybe less than that, but he's really fast. Okay, the modeling, after we've got the reference image, modeling, the key to modeling is good reference image. Good reference character references, good character sheets. If you don't have good character sheets, or if they're not accurate, it's very difficult to model. So a lot of this actually falls into place when you have references that can tell you what to do, because it's always, without exception, faster to trace than it is, well, not always, sorry, but it is faster to trace than it is to conceptualize something in your head, at least in the modeling stage. Okay, so you don't want to start modeling until you've got some kind of reference sheet to model with. Generally, you want the character to be facing, to have a front view, a profile view, and maybe a three-quarter view as well. Right, the skeleton, fairly straightforward. I use the HIK generator to just generate some joint skeletons and rename them appropriately, and then we get into the rigging stage where we're creating the body controls. And this will take up a little bit of time for, you know, just creating all the curves and appropriately grouping them up. Remember, this stage, when it comes to the rigging stage, is actually the most critical stage. You have to be really careful, because if you get something wrong here, well, if you get something detrimentally wrong here, it will not get better. It doesn't get better down the track. So everything needs to be correct, as accurate as possible, in the body rigging stage. And just be really careful. I've mentioned that in the videos before. Take your time on this part. This does take a long time to do. It's probably the most complex and time-consuming aspect of creating your rig, because if you don't have a rig that works and is efficient for the animator, then, well, you're going to have to scrap that rig and start again. So make sure you make a rig that's versatile and robust, and you should be fine. And assuming you've done all that, we move on to the creating the face controls. Again, fairly easy, much simpler than creating the body controls, except you probably have a little bit more, a few more controls to make on this, but most of them is just duplicating and applying them to certain aspects of the faces. Again, for versatility, I've created a master control that can control the main proportions, and then the joint and the joint controller, just to control the joint when it comes to deforming the face itself. Now, face rigging is actually, again, a lot of tweaking, a lot of just testing to see how it works, and just matching, mixing and matching them up to the face controls. It takes a little bit of time, but unlike the body rigging segment, it's not as unforgiving, okay? So if you get some of these little aspects wrong in terms of its weights, you can actually change them later. So you're kind of in the safe zone when you get to the point of a face control. Now, the next part, after we've done, and normally in a pipeline, I think if you have more people, what they would do is they would be creating the body rig, like a separate party will be creating a body rig, and then another separate party will be creating the modeling. And then after they've done the model, assuming the model doesn't need any more changes, you can actually start UV mapping this character out. The only reason why I've put this on one timeline is that I'm just assuming kind of the worst possibilities, that you will be, just one person will be taking it from, you know, modeling to completion. Okay, so UV mapping is fairly simple. It doesn't take very long. Again, a very technical aspect of it. It does get a little bit boring, but it's not that bad once you get started into it. And then, of course, you've got the texturing, which is the fun stage. And then in this stage, you kind of want to take your time. This kind of varies in terms of how much work and how much time you'll take on that. It will depend on the style, the method, and basically what you are actually after. Sometimes when it comes to more photorealistic, the more photorealistic it is, the, you know, the longer it will take, obviously. So, but if you're doing something as simple as just painting out the cartoon, then hey, it's not a big deal. And of course, you need to leave time after that for tweaks, because sometimes tweaks aren't, you can't really tweak any additional extras until you probably start the animation stage and just see what you actually need. So with the tweaks, you just go back and add some extra weights to the rig or to make some of those custom facial expressions. Okay, so all in all, this entire pipeline, okay, assuming you don't do what I do and start recording and creating your tutorials all at the same time, assuming you've got everything down and you know what you're doing, this will take you about 80 hours. Okay, so, and if you're kind of beginning, just expect maybe double that, maybe 160 hours to work on this. So that's about maybe a month, 4 weeks, 8 hours a day, something like that. It is quite long, but if you think about it, once you've done the body rigging and once you've made face controls with future models in mind, this kind of goes away. And then suddenly you've got just, concept art, modeling, you know, mapping out your UVs, and then texturing, and that's it. And then, you know, you can just apply the body rig, and suddenly the body rig doesn't take very long. So think ahead with any future models you want to do. Very, very efficient. And if you get to the point where you don't need to rig again, you've saved that specific rig for future models, then really modeling and texturing, all that stuff will only really take maybe 40 hours, maybe even less. So it's not that bad if you think about it in that respect. So that's the entire pipeline. That's the of creating a model. I haven't added animation because animation actually takes much longer than all of this combined, and that actually depends on how long the movie is, and it's a it's a very, very tedious process, I can tell you that. It's creative but very, very tedious, and I've seen some animators work and they spend maybe a month doing probably 10 seconds worth of animation. So you can see how these feature film guys kind of work. They It's pretty funny. And the other funny thing is that animators tend to be the unsung heroes, so if you ever see an animator, make sure you give him a hug. They're the invisible people making the character act and work. And it's kind of funny, the voice actors usually get all the stardom and probably the higher pay as well. So they end up, the voice actors end up being the ones who take the limelight away from the animators. Whereas the animators are probably the ones actually doing most of the acting in this particular case. But what we have here is a complete rig. We've done everything. This entire process can be a little bit daunting if you're starting out. That's okay. I've had that myself. We've all had that. But honestly, find a model that you want to model. Like, find something that you enjoy doing. I personally enjoy doing this. I wouldn't sit here and start modeling a car, because honestly, that's not me. That's personally not how I like to work. I like to use, you know, organic biped characters and just work from there. And if you model something that you really enjoy, you'll find that you'll be able to stay motivated through the course of the process. And you may get discouraged when you hit, say, a problem that you can't figure out and you're struggling with that. And hey, honestly, if that ever happens, which by the way, it probably will happen, just go in the forums and talk to people. Ask around and say, oh, what do I do here? And people will be more than happy to tell you. So give that a go. And I certainly look forward to seeing some models from other people. If you do make any models, please let me know and just show me, and I'd like to see them. Just post them up in the forums and send me a link in the private message or something, and then we'll definitely go for that. So there you have it, guys. Congratulations for finishing this off. We will continue to pump out more tutorials. Other tutorials I will pump out include maybe cloth sim. The reason why I didn't include it in this particular character series is because I just wanted to get the basic character out for you. Okay, and I didn't want to work in those little tiny details until, well, at least I'll leave them for another tutorial for later. So guys, if you like this content, please subscribe. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you next time.